Good evening. The teenager accused of partying at a city nightclub after being alerted he's tested positive to COVID has been arrested and charged. Ralph McIntosh was to have spent tonight behind bars and face court tomorrow before an about-face by police.
Emerging from the police city watch house, the 19-year-old party boy apparently admitting he'd made a big mistake.
Do you have anything to say to the South Australian community?
Ralph McIntosh now accused of a foolish COVID breach which sent hundreds of people into isolation and shut down multiple city businesses. Police say he continued to party at the Loverboy nightclub on Friday the 17th of December after he received an alert from SA Health informing him he was COVID positive.
What were you thinking?
Guys, I won't be answering any questions.
Why not? Don't you think you have to explain to the South Australian community?
Few answers from McIntosh today, but eventually he'll have to justify his actions, now facing a maximum penalty of a $20,000 fine or 2 years in prison, having been charged with failing to comply with directions under the Emergency Management Act. McIntosh was arrested earlier this morning, police releasing a statement saying he had been refused bail and would spend the night in a cell to face court tomorrow. But before long, that all changed and the teen was cut loose.
What do you got to say to the businesses and all those families who spent Christmas in isolation?
Deanno De Corso, among many forced into isolation, having been at Loverboy that night, meaning she spent a week in quarantine, missing her family Christmas.
It's just like missing out on quality time with families. I know a few people that tested positive, so they were all out of Christmas. They weren't allowed to attend.
She believes that if McIntosh is proved guilty of the charge against him, the punishment should be severe.
I believe that he does need jail time.
The Premier today with this warning to others.
I think this serves as a lesson to every single South Australian that they've got to abide by these restrictions. Otherwise, there are very heavy penalties on the individual, but also harsh conditions from those people who are victims of this thoughtless activity.
Following McIntosh's bail review, his court appearance was pushed back from tomorrow until February next year. It's then we're expected to learn more about the allegations against him and his side of the story. But Edward, for now, he's free to go about his business.
Okay, thanks for those details, Keziah. On what was meant to be SA's Freedom Day, our state's COVID-19 outbreak spiralled even further out of control. Hospitalisations increasing as Omicron spreads through the community, forcing the state government to throw everything it has at our overwhelmed vaccination clinics.
Inside our hospitals tonight, 36 COVID patients, including six under 19, three of them young children. Five people are in ICU as our case numbers climb to another unwanted record, 995.
It's doubling every 3 to 4 days. We've had to take action.
The Omicron wave, meaning we're living with harsher restrictions on the day they were meant to lift altogether. We still haven't hit 90% double vaccination for people aged 12 and over. And despite scenes like this at the Wayville Hub yesterday, with hundreds waiting hours hoping for a booster shot, the Premier insists the system is working well.
We've got an excellent booking system in South Australia for our vaccinations.
Despite the number of kids in hospital rising, 5 to 11-year-olds can't get a jab until January 12, and that's if they've already booked, because all of the appointments are filled for now. The state government's been forced to throw extra resources to get shots in arms faster, long queues forming at this new walk-in clinic at Port Adelaide's Town Hall, which opened today. And operating hours are being extended at Wayville and Enfield vaccine sites over the next week.
Our aim is to very significantly increase the capacity of vaccination and boosters in South Australia.
Testing sites are also still under pressure. This Port Adelaide drive-through clinic was forced to temporarily close today, and with reports some people have been waiting 5 days to get their swab result, the opposition's demanding the state government make rapid antigen tests free.
That can go a very long way to mitigating the risk to a lot of people in our community, but also providing relief on the very substantial testing queues.
But the Premier wouldn't commit to that, only saying
it is no replacement for the PCR test if you have symptoms.
Restrictions imposed to slow the Omicron spread are hurting businesses, and when it comes to compensation, there's still no word on when or how much operators will get. The Premier says he met with the Treasurer today and hopes to settle on a package by the end of the week. Edward.
OK, thank you, Kate. Three of Adelaide's major public hospitals have banned visitors due to the COVID crisis. The Royal Adelaide, Women's and Children's and Queen Elizabeth hospitals will only allow visits if a loved one is dying or for other compassionate reasons. Flinders Medical Centre is allowing patients just one visitor per day, and the same rule applies to Modbury and the Lower McEwen hospitals. But late today, SA Health warned that is subject to change.